Good afternoon, friends. Today I am going to discuss adsorption. So as you all know this chapter from your BSc level, so I will not go in details about the chapter. I will just cover all the important topics from where questions generally are asked frequently in CS and NET examination. So you all know that adsorption, it's a surface phenomena. So there are two types of adsorption, namely chemisorption and physisorption. So what is adsorbate and what is adsorbent, that everything you know. Adsorbate and adsorbent you know, and I will just discuss what are the factors that affects adsorption. So first is the temperature. So with decreasing temperature, more adsorption takes place. And the effect of pressure, when we increase the pressure, then the more adsorption takes place. So temperature and adsorption, this is indirectly proportional. And pressure and adsorption is directly proportional. So more the pressure is, more adsorption will take place. And it also depends on the nature of gas and the adsorbent on which adsorption takes place. Okay. So adsorption, since the molecules gets adsorbed, its entropy decreases. So delta S is negative. Delta S becomes negative. So what happens here? Del G is del H minus T del S. When delta S becomes negative, so this part becomes positive. So in order to make the reaction feasible, we have the delta H, that is the enthalpy change, as negative, which implies it is an exothermic reaction. So it's an enthalpy driven process, and this is an important formula. This is the formula for the rate constant for desorption. So it follows like Arrhenius equation, same as Arrhenius equation. So rate constant of desorption is basically proportional to the exponential of the activation of desorption, and it's temperature dependent like that. So this is the temperature dependency of adsorption. Okay, so tau is tau zero exponential Ea by RT, where tau is nothing but the lifetime of adsorbate, which is denoted by 1 by k desorption. So just to remember this formula, tau is tau zero exponential Ea by RT. So you will be given some activation energy value, will be given some temperature, and they will give some frequency factor, that is tau zero, and they will ask to find the lifetime of that adsorbate, that is the tau. Okay. So adsorption. So first, isotherm is the friendly isotherm, which says that the amount of gas, so this is the amount of gas adsorbed per unit mass of adsorbent, is directly proportional to P to the power 1 by n, where n is greater than 1. Okay, so x by m is k, P to the power 1 by n, and this k and n are constant whose value is depends on the nature of gas and the nature of adsorbent. So if we plot x by m versus p, we will get a plot like this, where you can see that at high pressure range, the x by m value becomes constant. That means it follows a zero order reaction. And in the initial phase, when pressure is low, it follows a first order reaction. So if we take a logarithm, then we will get log x by m equal to log k plus 1 by n log p. When we plot log x by m versus log p, we will get 1 by n as a slope and log k as the intercept. So just remember this thing, this formula. Next is the Langmuir isotherm. Langmuir isotherm is the main important part of this chapter, from where every year questions are asked in GATE also, in NET also. So Langmuir isotherm is monolayer chemisorption. Only monolayer adsorption takes place. So if you have a gas A, say it's getting adsorbed on a surface of a metal or something M on a surface. So what happens? It will form adsorbed species AM. And the rate of the forward reaction, that is the rate of adsorption, and Kd is the rate constant for the desorption or the backward state. So Ka by Kd is basically K, and this is the important formula, that is theta equal to Kp by 1 plus Kp, where theta is the surface coverage. So this K is basically Ka by Kd. So this is the important formula from where questions are asked. Now if the adsorption is dissociative type, like say the molecules like O2 or O3 gets adsorbed, what happens? They will dissociate first. like O2 will dissociate into 2O. So that's why I'm written in general, AN gets dissociated into N into A. So if this type of adsorption takes place, then theta in general formula, theta is Kp whole to the power 1 by N by 1 plus Kp whole to the power 1 by N, where N is the number of atoms which form after dissociation. So if it is a O2 molecule, so the N will be 2, so it will be half, here it will be half. If it is a O3, then it will be 1 by 3. Right? Okay. So we have two conditions for Langmuir adsorption, one at low pressure, one at high pressure. So what happens at low pressure? Just correlate here. What happens at low pressure? At low pressure, the Kp value is very, very less than 1. So we can neglect this 1. So in the numerator, we have Kp. In the denominator, we have Kp. So, sorry, at low pressure, I told the high pressure one. Okay, at low pressure, Kp is very, very less than 1. So it becomes 1 is very, very more than Kp. So Kp, we will neglect the Kp part in the denominator. So it will be theta equal to Kp. That is, theta is directly proportional to pressure. That is first order kinetics. So at low pressure, it follows first order. And high pressure, Kp is very, very greater than 1. So we will neglect this 1 value. So what happens? Theta is becoming 1. That is, theta is directly proportional to P to the power 0. That is a zero order reaction. So this is the plot theta versus P. And the plot is here, it is at low pressure, it's first order. At high pressure, it is zeroth order. And the intermediate pressure, it is of the order of 1 by N. So just correlate this one with this one. Let's see. This is same. Just the same. Okay. So we can write this theta value as V by Vm. What is V and what is Vm? Vm is the volume of the gas adsorbed on the surface. And Vm is the volume of the gas adsorbed corresponding. This is the volume corresponding to complete coverage. I mean, when all the molecules gets adsorbed to form a monolayer, it's complete coverage. That time, this is Vm. So V by Vm, we can write it as V by Vm. So just putting this here, putting it here, V by Vm equal to Kp by 1 plus Kp. So from here, we'll get P by V is equal to 1 by KVm plus P by Vm. So just try to memorize this formula. It's also important. This type of numerical came in GATE 2016. So in the plot of P by V versus P, the slope becomes 1 by Vm and the intercept is 1 by KVm. So you will be given some slope and intercept value from where you have to find the Vm value or the K value, like this. Okay. So now if two gases get adsorbed, here we have seen one gas is getting adsorbed. If two gases going to be adsorbed, so there should be a competition between the gases. So if gas 1 and gas 2 are adsorbed, then what will be your theta 1? It will be K1 P1 by 1 plus K1 P1 plus K2 P2. And theta 2 for the gas 2, it will be K2 P2 by 1 plus K1 K2 plus K2 P2. Okay. Now, what happens? If two gases are adsorbing, but one of them are following the dissociative mechanism, then what will happen for theta 1? Say gas 2 is undergoing dissociation, gas 2 and gas 1 is not undergoing dissociation. So theta 1 will be K1 P1 by 1 plus K1 P1 plus root over of K2 P2. Okay. And theta 2 will be root K2 P2 by 1 plus K1 P1 plus root over of K2 P2. Okay. Now we will move to the bed isotherm. So it is actually a multi-layer adsorption. So first layer gets adsorbed, then another layer, like this. And the adsorption of one layer doesn't depend on the other layer. So this is the equation you have to memorize. P by V into P0 minus P equal to 1 by VmC plus C minus 1 by VmC P by P0. Okay. So C is a constant which depends on a gas, a particular gas. And the value is exponential E1 minus EL by RT. So what is E1? E1 is the heat of adsorption of the first layer. And what is EL? EL is the heat of liquefaction of the gas. So from here we will get the C value. So if we plot the P by V into P0 minus P versus P by P0, we will get a straight line curve with slope C minus 1 by VmC and intercept 1 by VmC. Now, let's if you want to go to Langmuir from Pitt, what assumption you should take? You should take the assumption like C is very, very greater than 1, and P0, the standard pressure, is very, very greater than this pressure. Okay, and K, you should replace the K value with C by P0, just replace C by P0 by K, and theta, you have to write V by Vm as theta. So if you write this over here, then you will get back this equation, Langmuir. Fine. So the last part of this topic is the Gibbs adsorption isotherm. So Gibbs adsorption isotherm, what does it tell? So gamma 2 is equal to minus C2 by RT d gamma by dC2. Okay. So in Gibbs adsorption isotherm, it tells us that when we add some solute molecule, so C2 is the solute concentration and gamma 2 is the surface excess concentration. So if you add some solute molecule, there should be a change in surface tension, and due to the change in the surface tension, there should be some gamma 2 value. Means from here you can be able to tell whether the molecules are getting adsorbed on surface mode or whether the molecules are at the bulk mode. Like say you are taking some detergent and you are adding some detergent in water. So what happens when we add detergent in water? Your surface tension decreases. So we are increasing the concentration of detergent, the surface tension decreases. So this part becomes positive, that is the surface excess concentration become positive. So detergent molecules are more in the surface than in the bulk. But the reverse situation happens when we add inorganic salts in water. So what happens, then the surface tension increases when we add more salts. So this part becomes positive. So this is negative, that means the surface excess concentration is negative, that means the more molecules are present in bulk than the surface. So anyway, this is all for the adsorption chapter which you need to prepare for your upcoming CSIR NET exam, and I will make some videos on some numericals based on these formulas and these topics, and we will solve one by one using these formulas. Just to I will suggest you just to remember the important formulas like Langmuir adsorption isotherm, some dissociative type, then this formula, and then this formula, and then Bethe formula, Gibbs adsorption isotherm formula. And if you want, then you can take a snapshot from here. And that's all for this video. So in the next video, I will clear some doubts regarding the questions which came in the CSIR NET examinations. So I will solve all those. Okay, that's all. Thank you for watching.